In this video, I'm going to create the railings of this stair. It is not possible to create railings automatically from stairs right now, but we can create them from curves. So I will extract the edges of this stair slab and generate the railings from them. So first, I will select the stair, isolate it, and also hide the layer where the ground floor bitmap is. Now, from the curve from object toolbar, I'm going to run the duplicate edge command. I will select the edges of this stair slab, that by the way are not properly highlighted. And if I activate the control points, I can see there are too many, and this may lead to generate a very complex railing afterwards. So it will be a good idea to simplify these curves. For this first line, I will just delete it and create a new one. For this other curve, I see it already very simple, so I will leave it as it is. In case of these arched curves, first of all, I will join them into one single curve, so I will just move this control point next to the other one, select both curves and join them. Now, if I run the rebuild command under the curve toolbar, I can set a lower value of control points. So I will leave it to 15 number of control points and I will keep the grid to 3. Click OK and now I can see that it's a more simple curve that fits quite good with the edge of the stair slab. Finally, I will select the three resulting curves and I will join them into one single curve, as the command line indicates. Now, I'm ready, showing everything back again, to create the railing from the curve. So I will run the railing from curves command. I will select the wall fence style that comes along with the visual template. Right alignment, and finally I will select this curve.
Now we can also draw the middle stair fence just by running this railing command again. I will select this endpoint, also the same railing style. I will choose left alignment though and click on this endpoint of the stair slab. For the upper railing, the same. I will snap on this endpoint, same alignment, same style, and I will snap on this other endpoint. Now, I can see that these two railings doesn't start where the stair starts, so I can stretch them using their control points. But in this case, since this railing was created from a nerves curve, if I activate its control points, which are actually the same as the original curve, I can see that moving this point from here to this other point deforms the railing into a nerves curved shape. So I will undo this, and rather than just moving it to this point, I will stretch it following the direction of this first railing flight. So I will just select this railing, the stair and the other railing. I will just isolate them, and working from the front viewport, I will first draw an auxiliary line that goes from this point to this point. I can click on the tab key to constrain the direction of this line. Let me uncheck this. Intersection point to meet exactly the projection of the perpendicular line. And now I can select control point of the railing and move it from here to here. Before doing that, let's undo this, make sure the project snap is on, and repeat the operation. So we'll move it again from this point to this endpoint. There we go. Now we can do the same operation with this other railing, so I will activate the control points, which are just two in this case. Go to the front viewport, and again, move it from this point to this endpoint. I will just finally need to trim out these lower parts in order that these two railings meet the slab properly. So I will draw just an auxiliary volume up subtraction, make sure it intersects correctly with the railings, and from the VisualArq Edit toolbar, run the subtract solids command, select the railings, then solid. There we go. I can now just delete this auxiliary curve. There is one more railing in the ground floor, the one of the stair that leads to the basement floor of the house, which we are going to ignore in this tutorial so far, but we can draw it anyway. So, moving from the top viewport, I will uncheck the cut plane of the ground floor level so you can see the full stair. I'll make sure the project OSnap is on, and I will run the polyline command. So, snapping on this point, I will draw a polyline that goes to this point. I will switch to arc mode now. Click here, switch back to line, and end in this intersection. Now I can run the railing command from curves, select the wall fence, left alignment, and select the curve. We can see that we have these two railings overlapping each other, so we will need to trim out a part of one of them. But first, with this one, I can stretch it, selecting its control point and making it end at this position. So now I will select these two railings, isolate them, and from the front viewport I'm going to draw a polyline that I will extrude to generate a solid for the future subtraction. So I run the polyline command, I'll make sure the project OSnap is on, and click on this point, this intersection point. I will need to uncheck this intersection to find the projection of this endpoint, and finally close this curve. I will move it next to the railing and extrude it. We can just move it closer, and now we can run the subtract solids command, select the railing, select the solid, and there we go. We can also get rid of this curve.